Good afternoon. I'm sure everybody was, at least once in his own life, stirred, troubled by a dream. Because in dreams happen things which you never imagine could happen. And they come from our experience, but an experience which is far beyond our reach. It happened to me several times in my life, and it gave me new revelations of music and even of technical problems. It happened always with music by Chopin. I was impressed and stirred, I would say, by music by Chopin since my childhood. And I'm still, when I play Chopin, like in a kind of dream. I will allow myself to tell you a little story, rather two, if I'll have the time, which happened with an etude by Chopin. Everybody who plays the piano knows how difficult Chopin is from the virtuosity point of view, because still Chopin remains the highest expression of the virtuosity, of pianistic virtuosity. Or from the point of view of the variation of the sound, of the touch, of the inspiration, of the improvisation, because you have to render the genius of Chopin and not just the notes of Chopin. Because he describes all the human moods possible in connection with the whole world actually around, and all this stirs something inside oneself and gives personal feelings. It once happened that I was troubled by the etude in double thirds. It's a well-known piece because every pianist tries to play it. Some can play it, some others try it for a whole life and don't achieve it. Some pianists practice it for 7 years, some other for 7 months, some others for more or less. It happened that I was troubled with a problem. One night I had a dream that the great Arthur Rubinstein, came to me at home, and I asked him, how does he play that? And he took my hand, put it on the piano, and said, look, like that. Of course, in the morning, I was very keen to know what exactly he showed me, but of course, I couldn't discover. Then I went and I practiced. I practiced for a tour. I practiced the Tchaikovsky concerto, which I played, more than 150 times and so on. And at the end of the 2 hours of practice, I tried to play this etude. And all of a sudden, the nasty passage was going absolutely perfect. What I was doing was another fingering, and that was all worked in the subconscious. For whoever plays the piano knows how difficult it is to change the fingering which you use for many years. That was one instance when the subconscious worked for solving a technical problem. Another time, being quite ill, I had the feeling of death. And through a dream, I was revealed on how the first movement of the so-called funeral march sonata should be played. Now, since then, whenever I played, I have the same feeling, and I played in quite a different way than I would have ever played it if I wouldn't have had this dream kind of revelation. I will try to convey to you today, in three etudes, some of the moods, of the expressions of Chopin's genius. The first one is the Black Key etude, which is sparkling, champagne-like, joyful, playful, capricious, witty, subtle, and a little bit passionate, bubbling with passion and expectation, in a word, perfectly satisfied mood. The next one, the most contrasting one, is desolated, evocative, speaking right from the heart of the lost past, from far away, from the innermost profound regret, sometimes with resignation, with undertones of despair. Then at a certain moment, he gives us the feeling that he is restoring, maybe, life as it used to be, giving the impression of being carried away by an illusion of warmth, tenderness, and purity, and thereafter entranced by the poignant pursuit of the ideal image. The peak of the drama is the moment of renouncement when, tired and discouraged, one returns to disappointing reality, extinguishing little by little all hope until any light of the hallucination is dissipated into the misty nowhere. It ends in a kind of transfiguration. The last one is noble, full of pride, full of protest. It's tragic and rebellious, and it tends to bring a hope and victory.
Thank you. ארבעה ימים, תוך האזנה לשישה רסיטלים ביום, ישב מנהל התחרות לצד חבר השופטים הנכבד, שכלל מורים, מבקרים, מלחינים ופסנתרנים, והכל שמחים שסוף סוף עלתה התחרות על דרך המלך. מה היו ציפיותיו של חבר השופטים?
That at the beginning, it's something which is called talent. A certain capacity of understanding a language which is called music, and understanding through this language a lot of things, from the most idiotic to the most philosophical. It's all possible to say in music. In the middle, technical criteria for what is good and what is not good. You can say this man has a good way of phrasing, this one has a nice tone, or this style is better than the other. This is just the start of the judgment to me. This will give you a very accurate kind of playing, something which is very good to start with. It's like what would be for an actor to have a clear speech, a nice voice, a good presence, all that. But if he is really talented, this is related to some much deeper qualities. We are looking for that. I try as much as possible.
Immanuel Axe, מארצות הברית. Thank you.
Değerli seyirciler, bu programda sizlere dünyanın en ünlü piyanistlerinden birini, Mindru Katz'ı dinletme fırsatını bulabildiğimiz için mutluyuz. Biraz sonra Mindru Katz, Beethoven'ın Ay Işığı sonatıyla Chopin'in Opus 10 numara 3 Mi Majör etüdünü sunacak. Romanya'da dünyaya gelmiş olan İsrailli piyanist Mindru Katz, özellikle Beethoven ve Chopin yorumlarıyla ün yapmıştır. Dünyanın hemen hemen tüm kültür merkezlerinde konserler vermiş, en tanınmış orkestralarla çalmış olan sanatçının pek çok da plağı vardır. İlk dinleyeceğiniz eser, Beethoven'ın Opus 27, numara 2, Do diyez minör sonatı. Bir eleştirmen, Beethoven'ın ölümünden 23 yıl sonra, sonatın ilk bölümünün kendisine bir göldeki mehtabı hatırlattığını yazmış ve o günden sonra da eserin adı Ay Işığı Sonatı olarak kalmış. Sonat 3 bölümlüdür. Adagio sostenuto, allegretto ve presto agitato. eser Beethoven'ın Ay Işığı Sonatı'ydı. Mindru Katz şimdi de Chopin'in pek tanınmış bir etüdünü seslendirecek. Opus 10, numara 3, mi majör etüt. Bu eser belki de hafif müziğe çevrilen ilk ciddi eserlerden biridir. Yaşı 40'ın üstünde olan izleyicilerimiz biraz sonra Tristes, Hüzün adlı şarkıyı hatırlayacaklardır. Dinleyelim.
Thank you.
piyanist Mindru Katz'dan Chopin'in Mi majör etüdünü dinlediniz. Programımız burada sona eriyor sayın seyirciler. Hoşça kalın.
Thank you. Thank you.